Joanne, give me your impression of what happened here this morning regarding food and development in women's football.
Wayne, I'm so happy to say to you that what happened today is so profound. It actually sets a new benchmark for us in terms of planning and preparing for the development of the women's game. I mean, it highlighted a lot of challenges, but it has not highlighted any challenge that we cannot deal with. The most important thing with challenges, though, is knowing that they're there and being prepared to work around them. And with the passion and the excitement and the commitment that I heard from the people here today, I couldn't help but be moved and also motivated and moved to action.
The game in Trinidad and Tobago on the women's side is actually, you know, gaining a lot of momentum. It's getting as popular as the men's game. Mm-hmm. But we always sort of fall short when we come out of the Caribbean. Do you see any programs in place, anything in place where we could improve on that?
Well, first of all, you have to get your grassroots and your youth correct. And then when you've got that sound, it now builds a momentum. The girls are accustomed playing together, they're familiar with each other's play, they're familiar with the challenges, they've built the right physical strength. And really, the people that we're competing against when we come out of the Caribbean, they are actually playing together 4 to 6 months of the year. They're not coming together like we do to prepare for a particular tournament and do our best in the tournament. They are actually, they've got a psyche that's common amongst them because of the familiarity and frequency with which they play. And that is what we need to get to as well.
All right, with that being said, you from an administrative standpoint, do you see the association putting things in place to fund such initiatives?
I see us putting things in place. I see us. Funding is always a ticklish area. We are going to redouble our efforts to actually identify the particular funding, but we're also going to look at very creative ways of making it happen. So for instance, there's a vast corporate social responsibility program that our corporate sector gets involved in, and there are some very low cost items, or low cost to them items anyway, that we can encourage them to provide us, which will enable games to go ahead. For instance, movable goals, cones, simple items of equipment that make the difference between having a properly regulated game and one that doesn't fit the TTFA requirements. So yes, funding is always tricky. Yes, we're going to redouble our efforts, but we're also going to look at what creative ways are available to us to enable the games to go ahead.
Thank you very much, John.